Uh-oh.
Did you eat one already?
Sam, no. Don't look at your face.
That is my little brother, Steve. He's been yanking my chain for about 70 years. Ribs. Potato salad.
What is that? Corn?
Broccoli.
Broccoli.
Yeah.
Okay.
Barbecued broccoli.
Okay.
Currently, we're camped out up at Lake Tahoe. It's like 6,500 feet and it's usually nice and cool up there. But the reason we go to Lake Tahoe so often is Pearl has a sister and other family, a lot of other family over in Sacramento. And we've got family in Reno, my brother Steve and his wife Diane, our daughter Melissa, and Andy, our son. And so Lake Tahoe's right in the middle, makes it perfect. And in addition, some of our really good friends, Tom and Lori from Tom and Lori's RV Life, spend their summers in Reno. And Steve and Diane volunteered to host a little party for Tom and Lori and Pearl and I and Tinker. And we just had a great day in Reno. Ribs, potato salad, asparagus, frozen margaritas, and a lot of fun and laughter.
Obviously.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Practicing on my
Look at that.
Oh!
You got robbed. Smile, Lori, yeah. On candid camera.
No!
Nope.
Oh, so close.
I
will. I'm here. I want you fast and it got blurry.
At an angle.
Oh, shucks.
No, one of them.
Fancy with her.
Oh.
How do you get that, Steve?
go right down the right hand side.
Let's see. Oh, wait.
You hit that six.
Don't listen to him. Don't listen to him. I'm telling you, he's yanking your chain again.
Oh, Earl.
Good call, Steve.
Take
good ball.
Take a bow, lady.
That's how you do it.
So we're going to be in the Reno area for probably another couple of months. So, and we sure hope we get to see Tom and Lori again before they take off or before we head south to Yuma. But the next day, our daughter Melissa and Pearl, they drove over the mountain to Sacramento, where Pearl's got a 91-year-old sister, Helen. And Pearl and Melissa got to visit with Helen and her daughter and her, some of her other kids. And
Joey and Buster.
So they had a great day. Steve and Diane and I had a great day. And then we, Tinker and I headed back to Lake Tahoe and Melissa dropped Pearl off that evening. And we started packing up, getting ready to go do some boondocking. Okay, I gotta admit, I had a little trouble making this right-hand turn. But in my defense, it wasn't a 90-degree right-hand turn, it was like a 120-degree right-hand turn. So I had to back up back and forth a couple times to get in there, but I got in, and that may or may not make a future video. You just have to stay tuned to find out. Let's go down and see the campsite. And I think this is just an awesome boondocking location. It's up about 8,000 feet, 8,200 feet, and it's nice and cool. Down in Reno, it's 100 degrees, and up here, it's in the low 80s, maybe the mid 80s. And we just love it. Probably 5 acres. There is all kind of folks going up this road. There's a lot of campsites. but we're just not willing to take our big RV up that way. And then over here in the trees, there's people spaced out, three or four campers in there that you can't even see. We've got us a tri-tip smoking, turned out to be delicious. We got some really special friends, Ron and Kim, that helped us in the rally. They've attended our last two rallies, and Ron has just been a great partner in making that all work out. He took over the parking and lining everybody up so we all fit in, and we're really looking forward to spending a week with Ron and Kim up here in the middle of nowhere. Well, we thought we were in the middle of nowhere. The next morning, Pearl and I were out walking around, and we saw someone had come in and put up a chair and a table and was planning on camping right there in the same meadow as we were. As it turned out, it was Wayne and Rachel and their little three-year-old boy, Kai, and they were great. And they've been full-time in 7 years, very conscientious about giving everybody space and noise and all that kind of stuff. Perfect neighbors. And then just a little bit later, Ron and Kim showed up.
Hey, I'll give you a proper hug when we get in.
All righty. You're right on the edge, but yeah, you're good. You're perfect here.
Hey, it's good to see you.
Same here, buddy. That turned out not too bad. They don't have any solar, so they picked a spot where they had shade all day long. And as you can see, we picked a spot 90 degrees to them where we have plenty of sun for our solar panels. We never ran our generator, not for 1 minute, the whole 8 or 10 days that we were there. Absolutely great campground. I gotta say, camping with Ron and Kim remind me a lot of last year when we were camping with Computer Joe and Jeff and Lori. Everybody just chips in. One person cooks breakfast one day and then the other person cooks dinner or lunch, and it just rotates. You never even really have to talk about it. It just happens. We also had another good group of RVers that camped in the same area. These equestrian folks had their horse trailers and RVs built together. They parked on up the hill, away from everybody. They rode their horses. Another great group of folks to camp with.
Yeah.
And who doesn't love watching horses walking through your campground? One of the best things about camping on National Forest land or BLM land is there's not a whole lot of rules. But one of the bad things about camping in National Forest or BLM land, there's not a lot of rules. And as you can see, Wayne and Rachel, they weren't quite as lucky as we are with their neighbors. The second or third day that he was there, there was four or five RVs parked right behind him, within 40 feet, 50 feet, something like that. And two of them had razors that was racing around. Now they were pretty good with the razors. They didn't stir up a lot of dust and they weren't racing around. But it's still, there was a lot of room and there was plenty of campsites. Those folks could have camped a whole lot further away and let everybody have their space. It didn't bother us, but it's just sad to see people come and park
our friends Tom and Lori call it spoondocking, where you just ride up beside your neighbor. There's just no reason to do that out in the national forest.
Just a second, let me look down. Go stand up there with her, sweetie. Or all of you, all of you. You get in the middle, Ron.
All right.
Okay. I'm a big man.
All right.
So we're having fun in South Lake Tahoe. Ron's got all the ladies. Now let's go get all some casino chips, huh?
Hey, there you go. There you go.
Talk about
say, pretty good there, Ron.
Thanks, Bob. Thanks.
And a cold beer on top of it.
That was a pretty good day we had down there.
That was a good day.
Oh yeah, that was nice. So
did you learn any Spanish? You had great Mexican food. I think you'd come out of there talking Spanish.
Cheers. Cheers, Pearl.
Cheers, the lady said.
We spent one evening just looking at all the dates and stuff on me back to the 1700s. And then it had a river running through.
Got a little feast going here, Bob.
It looks like it.
So
you got a pretty good system for breakfasts, I tell you. We've had a couple of good ones over here.
Yeah. So it's, what is it? It's around 9 o'clock or so, 10 o'clock.
I think it's about 10, yeah.
Yeah, around 10 o'clock, so. They're in a great spot here. That's
how's
nice
the weather being?
Oh, great. You know, we've been very lucky this whole trip. For about a month and a half, 2 months, we haven't had probably a lick of rain, maybe a few drops here or there. But the weather's been here. It's been beautiful. Down at the low levels, at the 4,000 or 5,000 feet, it's probably 90 degrees today, maybe better, maybe 100.
I've seen 100 in Reno.
Yeah, probably 100 in Reno. And then today is probably going to be just shy of 90, or rather about.
Yeah, 85, 87.
So
look at that flag. There's just a hint of wind, just enough to feel good. It's a good day. The ladies are all happy, content. Liking that Jeep pretty good, Ron?
Yeah, Bob, this worked out well for us for our trips and stuff that we do. And we'd still like to get, you know, like a side-by-side or something like that. But this is really doing, especially like what we're doing today. You get a chance to go out in some of the back country, see some of the stuff, not worry about being in a car. And it's a pretty smooth ride, it's reliable. And we're dust-free being inside a vehicle as opposed to a Razor or something like that, side-by-side.
All sealed up. I'll tell you what surprised me the most is your lovely wife let me get up here in the front seat.
That was a pretty big perk there.
Okay, this is the next one on the agenda, Bob.
After the pickup camper?
That's
awesome, right?
This whole first view looking out here, you know, and, you know, if we get a chance, I got a hankering to go up those rocks over there. Those remind me of the when I was in Wyoming. So we're climbing around on them when I was a teenager.
Rocks where?
Those boulders out there.
Whoa. Yeah, the mountain.
Well, it's like the mountain, but they're big, big.
What
rock,
are you talking about?
Big rock formation out there. Yeah,
I doubt you can even get there from here.
I bet we can.
It's not that far away. It's not that far away.
It's not like it's 10 miles away.
Those look climbable.
Yeah, those look climbable.
So you think you can get from here, see those two rocks up there? Boulders? You think you can hike from here to there?
I'm willing to give it a try.
There you go.
I'm in.
What do you think, Pearl?
I'm out.
Why did we even invite you down here for? You serious?
Well, we'll have to try that before
we leave.
Serious?
Really?
Yeah, I think so. I think so, Bob.
Wow.
I think so.
All right, if y'all are going, I'll go.
Okay.
You gonna go?
I'm staying.
I'm in. Me and the dog.
I don't know if I say I can do it. I'll follow you.
You can do it.
Okay. I hope that tomorrow this time of day we're not saying that was a bad move.
Taking us a while to get up this mountain. We just
just gotta go up to there.
Yep.
Almost there.
Almost. Oh my goodness.
Oh my goodness. I'll get in the video, I bet you.
Oh, are you there yet, Rod?
Yeah,
awesome.
I'm there. Good day.
Woo!
Well, I think we all impressed ourselves. That was quite a hike, but we made it to the top, and Pearl suggested let's go out and celebrate. And so we ended up going to Martinville, a little mountain community, and had some delicious pizza, chicken wings, hamburgers. Well, the pizza wasn't that delicious, but we had a good time. The whole week was awesome. And I think that's kind of got you caught up. That's where we're at. We're gonna be up here for probably another month, if not two. Until either it gets starts snowing here in Tahoe or the temperatures start cooling off in Yuma. Either one of those will trigger us both heading south. So until we see you guys again next time, keep the wheels rolling. Stay safe. We'll see you at the next exit. So long, folks.
Oh my God.
You gotta follow it.
That's it.
I need the ball.
Hey, I can't.
Oh, no, ball don't work for me.
I need some English on this one. Or some French.
Or some love. Espanol.
For a lot of love.
Look at that.
Whoa. Hey, nice pickup.